like you saw the devil. Yo, look, I was born in 84, but I'm like 97 hoes. I went platinum off a brick, I cooked on 97 stoves. Yeah, I know the streets is watching, so I'm highly skeptical. Where I'm at in my career, when hit and I be set to go. Duct tape for the blocks, black tape for the strap. Bentley in the parking lot, ashtray.
Yeah, Cartess, Elliott Wilson, you heard the news, man. The butcher's coming. He's here.
Ah.
Betty. The plugs I met, it's time. You gave me the call. Is it time?
Man, it's time, man. I wanted you to hear it. It's time.
Ooh, secret location, man. Is this the raw, authentic hip-hop that we expect from the Griselda brand?
Definitely, man. The beats, production by Alchemist, Derringer. Ooh. You know what I'm saying? DJ Shay. So it's the formula. That's what I like to call it, the formula.
Oh, man, I got the head nod, man. I don't know if I'm ready for all this head nod I'm about to do.
You might not. You might not be ready. You know what I mean?
I feel like we're in New York City when we catch this vibe, man. It's gonna be amazing, man. I appreciate
no, real
you
shit.
Hitting me up, man.
No, let's do it, man. Let's do it, man. I appreciate you.
Plugs I met.
Ah. I feel like 97 hoes. It was 96. She pulled up in that 97 Rove. Drove it back and forth and went through 97 tolls. Real stories about drug money got me etched to stone.
This right here is the intro. I'm calling it Crowns for Kings, though. I'm saying we starting off like that.
This marathon shit, so let's see who first to the finish. If it's less than 100 racks, it don't deserve your attention, cause burdens come with it. My second test was serving a sentence. My first was make a brick jump like it was hurdling fences. Certainly, my last shit was a courtesy, nigga. And further we had bust downs before you heard of me, nigga.
So when he played you the Al Green, this joint, I'm sure you just was like, oh my God.
Yeah, man, when he played it to me, it was other niggas in the studio, so.
Oh, you had to be cool.
I had to jump on that. I'm like, oh, yeah. Nah, that's me. I'm like, no, that's me, and I just really.
Oh, amongst the crew, like West Side, other cats, and.
No, it was really Camino. Mm. It was really Camino in there, so I really had to move before him, cause he thirsty on dope beats, especially joints like that. So I heard the beat, I knew what I wanted to do with it, so I started it right then and there.
You attacked it.
Hell yeah.
That's what happens a lot of times in the session with a bunch of guys together, that creativity. And
yeah, man, because it's
just
like
seize the moment. You gotta almost claim your territory.
Right. You know what I mean? Cause you know everybody got their own thing and do what they do, and everybody, and Griselda, everybody shine how we shine. So
yeah.
Wes picked different beats from me, Conway picked his beats, I do what I do, but you know, when we all in the studio at the same time, there's all three animals in there, so, you know what I mean, you ready to show up.
Animal flowing that intro, man.
Derringer next.
Uh-oh.
You feel what
home
I'm saying?
Home team.
You gotta come Derringer next, and I'm gonna be honest. Derringer bring a certain type of animal out of me.
Still. Yeah.
Still, because
no success, none of that's changed that.
Right. Yeah. Still, because a lot of people don't know, like how we said, you hear that DJ Shay beat, I picked that. A lot of the Derringer beats that people hear me over, he picked those for me.
Mm, made them for you and mine.
Right. Like, yo, hun, I got this for you. Yeah. Yo, hun, I heard, I got this for you.
Like telling her in a suit or something.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. And I'll never question nothing. And I just go over it, and this is one of them joints, you know, Sharon, it's called Sunday.
See what I saw, a brick turned to a pot full of gold. Over that, spent my daughter's first birthday locked in a hole. Plot full of gold, came back stronger, I'm in control. Soft white from my block to the stove, not in the cone. Me and West like Stockton Malone, Gotti Capone. Niggas dressed like they copying hoes, Poppy Camone. Stop it, you know, you're not with the smoke.
That energy right there, that's that Derringer energy right there.
Stockton and Malone.
Yeah. I recorded, I did that at Alchemist House.
Oh, wow.
You know what I'm saying? You know.
A Cali?
Yeah, hell yeah. You know, Derringer and Al, they cook together a lot.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And that's just one of those sessions we all over there. I might do a Al joint, then do a Derringer joint. Do an Al joint, I'd be in there like that. You know what I mean? Going back and forth with those
niggas. Bust people out, you'd be like in sunny California cooking up like that raw, like gutter.
Man, that's a fact, because I be having the streets with me everywhere I go. I be having the goons with me. And I stay in tune, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, I stay in tune with everything. And that's important, you know what I mean? The niggas who stay in tune with shit, those be the smart niggas, man. Yeah. So I stay in tune, man. I still got that
feeling. I was like, yo, let's do this interview. He's like, who should I set up with? He's like, me.
Yeah, that's a fact. You know what I mean? That's a fact. You know, I got to go to Al next, man.
The producers are kind of the co-pilots, right?
It's like
process. I think that's,
hell yeah.
That's also unique about you guys at Griselda. It's like your connection with the producers you work with. Mm-hmm. It just seems like just true partnerships and multiple partnerships going on at one time.
Man, that's a fact. Derringer, I mean, Alchemist, he the same way. if he got something for me, he'll hit me up, and he is tailor made for me.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? And I like that. I'm saying sometimes I pick through the badge, but if you got, I trust the producers I work with. So if you got something, shoot it my way. You know what I'm saying? If
so
I like it.
So even if you don't necessarily connect right away, you'll try to work with that track. Yeah. If the producer had you in mind, you give it that respect.
That's a fact, because I'm trusting their expertise.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? And the names that I'm naming is the dudes who I feel comfortable around. I'm not just doing that for anybody. Anybody can't send me anything. But you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I trust those dudes. And this joint right here called, I Took the Money to the Plug House. You know what I'm saying?
That's the whole time I took the money to the plug house?
Yeah, yo. And when Al sent this to me, he was like, yo, I got something for you on some rubber bands. He said, I got something for you on some rubber bands and weight two type shit. I'm like, oh, okay, you do. I'm from Buffalo where it's cold in summer. All we know is hustling, lower numbers than the Ochoa brothers. They broke the code, now we exposing suckers. They know the flow disgusting, a Griselda feature, blow your budget. Been through hell, had to make it, I was well validated, kept my family in my scale, calibrated. 2012, I'm in sales for a sale, had no patience. All these cats acting gangster, all the crack,
like rock and roll, rock and roll music.
Rock and roll music, you know what I'm saying? Joints like that, you know what I mean? Like, shit that inspired me to write that is so crazy, it's just so real, the shit that I'm saying in that song. You know what I mean? That's why I'm giving niggas every aspect of the game. I'm literally telling niggas about being in the streets, fucking up, going to prison, and your bitch fucking around on you. You know what I'm saying? Every aspect. Niggas don't, these dudes don't, they had never mentioned nothing like that. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm giving people, when I talk about this shit, I'm saying something in the music that I probably won't even give in a conversation.
Yeah, it comes out more naturally that
exactly,
way.
Exactly, exactly. Yeah. And those songs are important to me because those are the ones that stand out. Those are the ones that stand out. Those are the ones they remember you for when you say
so how do
shit
you feel
like
when
that.
You hear it back? Does it make you think, damn, should I share that? Or do you ever hesitate with that to be like, am I gonna share this with the world? Did I get too real with it? Like,
I always wonder like that. Even on that song, I'm saying, everybody on that hook, I'm saying it's like, a name of a person who told on their best friend. Like, that's Buffalo shit. It's Buffalo politics. Like, it's a nigga who really did what he did on the stand.
Yeah.
And I put that in the record. I don't know how niggas gonna feel about that, but I'm reporting live from the streets. Mm. You feel what I'm saying? And it's like, I always think, like, do I get too real? You know what I'm saying? Female know who I'm talking about in that song. Like, is she gonna hear the song and wanna,
yeah.
You know what I mean? But it's part of my story. And,
yeah.
And that's what the people wanna hear, I think. You know what I'm saying? That stand out to the people the most, you know what I'm saying? They can identify with normal shit like that, because a lot of people going through that, but they not necessarily going to speak on it.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? That's the difference from me and them, and I'm going to put it in a song, so. You know what I'm saying? Talking about how I was friends and family, it was fuck both.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's like, the drug game would do that to you. You giving your family drugs, or you taking drugs from your family, you know what I'm saying? And over money, you know how people get. It don't matter who it is, so. Like, that's real shit. But man, this is what people gonna fuck with this song. This
the untitled work right
now.
This
the untitled shit, man. It's that Benny and Pusha T. By the time y'all hear it, it's gonna have a name.
With Pusha T on it?
Yeah,
oh,
this is
man.
And this is the plugs I met. You feel what I'm saying? plugs I met.
She lost focus for a second.
You know what I'm saying? It's like,
we know what this is.
You know what I mean? And shout out to Broke, because to be honest with you, I wouldn't have felt right without him on it, calling it that. You know what I'm saying? So shout out to Bro, man. Amazing talent, amazing.
How did you guys connect to come
and
here?
I just hit him up. I met him before at a Def Jam party.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? And I knew he was aware of the music.
Yeah.
Through like a third party.
Mm-hmm.
You feel what I'm saying? So, and I know what cloth he cut from.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? I found that out from some other niggas. Like, yeah. Nah, he official. So I'm like, okay, I'm gonna hit him up. And he hit me right back. He was like, I got you. You know what I'm saying? Exchange numbers in. I mean, good dude, man. You know, niggas like that. Niggas like me be needing that inspiration.
Mm.
You feel what I'm saying? So, shit. That Benny and Pusha T shit.
Looking like you new gangsters pointing guns at the camera. Never. I bet you niggas practice in the mirror. Brick of money to your earlobe. Six picks, same brick. Something's weird, though. They say a hero's nothing but a sandwich. The 488 coming through like the praying mantis. My bitch has got
nasty right there. I like that hop. I like that hop. You know what I'm saying? I like that hop. I think that's gonna be for everybody, man. You know what I mean? We all talking about the same shit. It's just the beat selection that you pick that diversify a record.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I think people gonna fuck with that. I play that, they like, yo, you need to put that on the radio. You know how niggas is. I mean,
you said I left the game, but I don't love them less. So what did you say?
I left the game, but I don't love y'all less.
Yeah.
So I did this for the plugs I met. You know what I mean? Just let everybody know the same thing I was talking about. I'm still, even though I'm on a bigger and better things, I'm still inspired by that life.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? And, you know, just an ode to them, man. You know, like I said, man, I be back home, not even back home, or I be in LA with the homies, or I be anywhere I'm at in the city. And I just be seeing, like, niggas still getting to us. Niggas is still outside.
Mm.
You know what I mean? And that's real for them, because I know how real it was for me. And now my hands is clean, and I just wake up and that's a blessing, man. I mention that all the time, because, man, it's a blessing knowing where I came from. I know everybody come from the bottom and come from the hood and got their own adversity that they dealt with to be who they are. But I'm speaking on mine, and I know I just basically was in the shark's mouth.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, real shit. People wearing BSF gear to probation. They probation officers telling them that they can't wear it. We a gang. You feel what I'm saying? It's a point in time where people telling me to stop repping it because it's hot. Like, yo, it's hot. Stop saying that.
This is yourself from it.
Yeah. You feel what I'm saying?
I want you to do that.
No, real shit, man. I had homies who fell back from me. Let me play this joint right here. This joint called Breakdown.
Breakdown,
because, you know what I mean? You if you a hustler, man, you got to have a breakdown hustle.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I be telling niggas, it's like this. All these niggas be on their songs talking about weight and all that. They did this and they did that. To be honest with you, when you selling weight to these hustlers in the streets, those are niggas that tell on you. Real shit. Those be the niggas that tell on you. Mm. I fuck with the fiends too, man. Breaking shit down. So I had to make a song about that breakdown.
The shit was rough, I had to make tough decisions. Thinking back over ties that I cut with scissors. So much powder on the counter, I gotta dust the kitchen. And the price is so low, they think the plug a midget. I ain't stumble over luck and get it. It ain't that, you know I put mine up. They go to clubs and spend it. Run that flex shit, I was still juggling business in the trap. Me and J-Rock bagging bundles in it.
Yeah, you know them beats that cry to you. You know what I mean? Shout out Ice Rocks. That's one of them fucking beats that cry to you. That's another one. As soon as I heard that shit, I'm like, damn, there's a whole bunch of rap niggas in the studio. I'm like, damn, they're turning that off.
You gotta go get it?
Damn, they're turning that off. It's mine, please.
Oh, you that's that. The volume.
Yeah. Like, nah, I need that. Don't even play that. Tuck that. For me. You know what I'm saying? Real shit.
Well, you got a lot of heat to tuck. You definitely passed that car test.
Oh, man. Beautiful. Because I don't got a license. I got to pass that test. The butcher coming. Ah. Big Griselda, Black Soprano.
Yeah, car test, TIDAL.